Ladies and gentlemen, g'day g'day and welcome back to the channel. My name is Economics Mate and in today's video we are going to be talking about the bottom three, or should I say top three, worst tanks at T10. And I mean, is it any surprise that some of these tanks I'm going to be talking about are at the bottom of the barrel right now? Is there any reason why? There's a few. And namely, it's because Wargaming has kind of just forgotten about these tanks. Well, not forgotten, but just left these tanks to just fend for themselves, right? Everything else around them has been buffed. Everything else around them has, there's new tanks that have been introduced and have better game mechanics and just better all-round in terms of statistics. And these tanks have just been left on the back burner and they just sort of become irrelevant in this day and age. So this is, in my opinion, the top three worst tanks at T10, and I wouldn't recommend most people to be playing them. Now, don't get me wrong, a good, like an amazing player in these tanks will definitely make them work, but it's not for everyone. I feel if you want to enjoy your match, maybe not play these tanks. Regardless, here are my top three. Coming in at number one, no particular order, is the Object 268. Now, the Object 268, a few years ago, was insane. It was crazy. It had the one of the highest penetration values for a standard round in the game, right? That and the Jaegerul, or the Jagdpanzer E100, they both had insane penetration values, right? They were great tanks to play. Specifically, the Object 268. It was fantastic to play. It was amazing. It had a very troll armor profile. The gun was insane. It was fantastic to play. It had good gun depression, decent gun arc, and it was just a fun tank to play all round. And it was one tank destroyer that I really wanted to get when I first started. Well, not when I first started, but when I was progressing in the game and I wanted the tier 10 Soviet tank destroyer, I wanted to get that tank. And I did, and I loved it. Nowadays, playing it, not so much. It's lost that charm. It's lost that ferociousness that it once had as a tank destroyer. Now it just sort of is very meh. It's mid, right? As the youngsters say, it's very mid. I would say it's very average. It's average, but because it's average, it's become quite bad, right? It lacks that incredible gameplay that it used to have, and that insane playstyle that it used to have back in the day. Now it's just, you just jump in it, you play a couple games, and you realize, you know what, man, everything else around it is just so much better. Just play a different tank destroyer. This is rubbish. I want to play this. Meh. It's meh. It's meh. It's not fun anymore. It's kind of terrible now. It's like, meh, it hasn't changed. Stayed the same for so many years. Meh. So that's my number one. Again, no particular order. I wouldn't recommend buying the Object 268 at the moment or playing it. It's, if you want to get it because you want it in your garage, fair enough. You know, if you've got it in your garage, and I'm assuming most people have it in the garage and they haven't played it for so long, it's because it's not fun anymore. You get wrecked by every other bloody tank at T10. You might as well not play it at all. So that's my number one. Coming in at number two. This used to be a tank that I adored. This used to be a tank that I loved playing. That I absolutely adored playing. And a tank that, unfortunately, was very close to my heart and it is no longer. And that's the T110E4. Now, some people might have their opinions on that and say, oh, but the T110E4 is actually a very nice tank. I always get masteries in it and I do very well in it. Fantastic. But the majority of the player base are not pro players. In fact, the majority of the player base cannot play the T110E4 properly. And it's a shame because the T110E4 at one point was an amazing tank destroyer. It was so good. It literally dwarfed the T110E3. And then the T110E3 got buffs left, right, and center, and then it got the engine boost, the big one, and it became so much fun to play, and so much better. And it's a tank that I will always play over the T110E4 now. My T110E4 just sits in the garage, doesn't do anything. I might jump in it every now and then, but I don't play it as much as I do the T110E3. It's because it's just, as I said, it's just been kept alone. It hasn't been buffed in recent years. It's everything else around it has come in new and improved, and there's different tank destroyers now, and it's just sort of left. It's one of the OGs in the game. It's one of the original tank destroyers in the game, but it's just sitting there. it doesn't get played. I rarely see T-124s in battle anymore, which is a shame, because it's always been a nice tank, but now it's just sort of overshadowed by everything else. So that's my number two. Again, no particular order. Not saying these tanks are particularly just horrible, they're not, but they're just really average at the moment, and they're not good anymore compared to what they used to be, and compared to the tanks that we have now that are quite cooked. That's my number two. Number three. This one, again, bit of a sad one, but, I mean, there's not much we can do. It's just how it is. It is still decent to play, but you can probably tell where I'm going with this. It's the IS-4. Now, the IS-4, back in the day, was insane. Like, the IS-4 was the heavy tank to play. If you were a pro player, that was the tank that you played. Now, keep in mind, I was going to say the FV-215B, but recently, I've seen in tournaments and in competitions, right, that there's been pro players that have been playing the FV-215B a lot recently. And it's made me think, made me rethink my sort of opinions on it, and to think, oh, right, okay, you know what, maybe this tank is actually pretty good. And there's a reason why the IS-4 is not played as much anymore. And it's been replaced by tanks like the WZ-111-5A, or the IS-7, or the Super Conqueror, right, or the Concept 1B, because it's not as good as it used to be. It's sort of just been left alone. It's not as good as it used to be. There's tanks, all the other heavy tanks around it that just absolutely blitz that tank. It's just a okay heavy tank. It's still got pretty nice armor, but armor doesn't mean anything if you can't really utilize that to its full potential. If you've got every other heavy tank in the game that can basically penetrate you, left, right, and center, you can still bounce shots. If you know how to play the tank, you can still bounce shots, but you're not going to get the damage that often anymore. But, like I said, it's disappointing that the IS-4 has just been left alone and hasn't really been given the love that it deserves. It was one of my favorite tanks before the IS-7 became ultimately one of my favorites. And it's a shame. And I remember back in the day with the IS-4, you started the tank with the stock T-7 D-22 122mm gun, or D-20 122mm. Which had ridiculously stupid penetration. Like, as when I say stupid, I mean it had such low pen, it was really crap to play. And you had to research the Top Gun, which was crazy to think about back in the day, but that's how it was. But yeah, those are my top three worst tank let me rephrase that. That is my top three worst T10 tanks in the game right now. It's a shame, but it's what happens when so many different tanks are brought into the game, and the ones that have been there for a while are just left alone, and, you know, anyway. Let me know in the comments down below what you think your top three worst tanks in T10 are, and let me know what you thought about the choices I picked, and whether or not you agree with me or not, and whether you want to strangle me and throw me off a cliff. I don't know. Anyway, I'll see you all in the next one. Peace out. Peace in the Middle East. Yeah. Cheers, fellas.
Right. I will catch you soon. Thank you all very, very much for watching. Bye-bye. Happy tanking. Bye.